my testimony after hearing what the last lead singer for the Duke choir said. God put it in my spirit. What I've been hearing in my spirit this whole night is deliverance. And I'm going to give my testimony. I started graduate school at North Carolina State in the spring of 2005. And that whole time, God was dealing with me. He was putting me through a lot of things that just seemed crazy. All the crazy fast, and every time I came home, when I would pray, it would be for hours. And I was budgeting my time, but it just seemed like when I got to my test, I just couldn't get the minimum score. It would be just below. I would be fine on my projects, A's on my homeworks, but my midterms and finals just would just bring my grade down. Whether it was a B, supposed to be an A, I have a B minus because of my final. I was supposed to graduate December of 2006. I'd had academic trouble. I had been kicked out of graduate school, and I wrote a letter and they let me back in. And I made all A's that semester. I worked hard. All A's. But this last test, I had an A come in, the guy was gonna write a letter of recommendation for me to go on to the PhD program. I took this last test. I thought I aced it. I made a 57. He called me in his office and said, I'm gonna give you a C. We went over the test, he saw that I just made a couple careless mistakes here and there, but he said, there's nothing I can do. I'm gonna give you a C. And I'm like, what am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to tell my parents? I'm supposed to graduate in 2 days. He said, it's not my problem. Talk to the Department of Graduate Programs, Director of Graduate Programs. I walked across the stage anyway, in my robe. I called it a faith walk, because I knew God was gonna bring me out. But I had never been so depressed in my life. The past 2 years, I had been working so hard. I knew this was what my purpose was. God gave me, Minister Wright talked about scholarship. He said, if you go back, I didn't want to go back to NC State. He said, if you go back, I'll give you a full ride. That first semester I went, took out a loan, and the rest of it was paid for, full ride, and then some. But I'm like, it's all the waste. Here was, I had a 297. To get out of the graduate school, you had to have a 3.0. They would not bump me up. All of last year, I prayed, like, Lord, please let me in. I kept going back to professors, asking them, please, I'll do anything. I'll do a special project. I'll take a class over. Just let me in. I want to do this. I made a mistake. They're like, no. I kept going to different people. I kept going to different professors. I didn't have an advocate, or so I thought. God directed me to talk to a lady in the minority engineering program. I just thought I was just going there to vent. But there was a professor in there, the black professor, Dr. Mitchell. She said, why don't you go talk to Dr. Mitchell? I felt like, what's that gonna do? But I went, I listened anyway. And then Dr. Mitchell became my advocate. He thought it was only gonna take a couple of days to let me back in. Turns out people started lying on me, said I wasn't doing my work, wasn't showing up. He was like, man, it's not looking like they're gonna let you in. Because he had the same situation. So we just kept going back, we kept writing letters, kept doing this and that. And I was just feeling more depressed. I lost my fellowship. That was my way of paying for school, paying for my apartment, paying for my gas, paying for my food. I had to drain all my savings. At the last minute, God gave me a job just to sustain me. But I still was just feeling so low. But God was using this to speak to me in another way. It became to the point that every time I'd get on my knees and pray, I would see scriptures in my spirit. And I wouldn't know exactly what it said to open the Bible. And it all had to do about paths. He gave me scriptures in Proverbs talking about, you know, all the ways of pleasantness and paths of peace. He gave me scriptures in Isaiah talking about he'll make a way in the wilderness. He gave me scriptures saying that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. So I'm like, okay. So we kept petitioning. I was still getting angry. You know, my spirit knew I was getting out, but my flesh was getting angry. I was like, I'm going to sue these people. I had lawyers lined up, ready to take my case. I wanted to